Welcome to the lesson on perimeter and area. In this lesson, we will discuss how to find the perimeter and area of basic quadrilaterals. Now, by definition, the perimeter is the distance around a figure or a polygon. So to draw a random polygon, we'll draw a quadrilateral, for example. We'll give each side a measurement, 6, 7, 8, and then the big one will be 10. Now, to find a perimeter, I want to know what all those sides equal up to together. So I'm going to add 6 plus 7 plus 8 plus 10. And as I carefully do the addition, I realize that I get 31. So the perimeter of this four-sided figure is 31. But we can always apply rules, and when we have information about that polygon, that quadrilateral, we can apply the rules to make our life a little bit easier. So I have this rectangle with the sides 8 and 3. Now, even though each side does not have a distance, I know that two sides of that rectangle are 8 and two sides are 3. So I can set up a multiplication problem. 2 times 8 plus 2 times 3. 16 plus 6 will give me a perimeter of 22. I look at a second example with a square. Now remember, a square has all equal sides. So if I'm given the length of one of those sides, 5, I know that square is going to be 4 times 5 to give me a perimeter of 20 because each side is 5. So again, 4 times 5 will give me 20. Area, on the other hand, is a measure that describes the space an object takes up, everything inside of an object, the amount of space that's in between those sides of that polygon. And we measure it in square units, like square inches. To illustrate the concept of area, we can start by drawing a rectangle. And in that rectangle, I can imagine that my width is going to be 4 boxes wide, and my length will be 8 boxes wide. Now, my goal is to figure out how many boxes are inside my rectangle. Well, rather than count the boxes by drawing them all out, I can kind of set up a multiplication problem. If I have 4 rows of boxes and 8 columns of boxes, I can multiply that to get an answer of 32. 4 times 8 will give me 32 square boxes, or in this case, 32 square inches. Now, with area, many of our related quadrilaterals have similar characteristics. I could take a parallelogram and a rectangle with similar dimensions and ultimately realize that they could have the same area. Regardless of how the shape might be slanted or drawn, with the similar dimensions, the area will be the same. But let's take a look at some practice. Let's start off with a parallelogram. Now, that parallelogram is going to have a side of 6 and another side of 4, but a height of 5. So in order to find the area of this parallelogram, I got to multiply the length and the height, or the base and the height. So 6 times 5 will give me 30. The 4 might be used to find perimeter, but in this case, we won't need it. The next shape I'll take a look at is a rectangle. And let's imagine that rectangle, with applying all its rules, has one side of 12 and another side of 7. Knowing that rectangle's rules, I don't need to know the other sides and know that 12 by 7 will give me 84 square units for the area of that rectangle. Let's do one with area and perimeter. So I have a square, and this square has side lengths of 5, so all the sides are 5. So to find its perimeter, or to find its area rather, I'll do 5 times 5, and that will give me 25. Now to find its perimeter, because it has 4 sides, I'll do 5 times 4 to give me 20. When it comes to the area and perimeter of quadrilaterals, the connection is strong as many of our houses, much of our farmland, many of our cities are based upon these regular four-sided shapes and knowing the distance within them and around them.